another white male. I'm very suspect of that this year going into a Democratic primary with women doing well in the African-American base of the Democratic Party. I'm not sure it's the time to dominate a white man.
Is it time to have somebody of color and a woman and somebody younger? But as a white guy, are you trying to calculate whether or not this is the right time for you?
It's a nagging issue that has completely enveloped the Democratic Party and frankly the media apparatus. Like, can you be white, or even worse, a white male and win the nomination? The obsession took on a whole new level of absurdity with the publishing of this piece from CNN's political reporter Nia Malika Henderson. Beto's excellent adventure drips with white male privilege. Here now with reaction, Candace Owens, communications director of Turning Points USA, and D. Dawkins Haigler, who's a former Georgia state legislator and a Democratic strategist. Ladies, let's get right into it. By the way, apparently this week, I am the newest thing in white privilege, thanks to Areva Martin, who is Kamala Harris's close confidant. And Fred, Candace, you and I covered something similar to this and where we are in false narratives on Fox Nation. But this is identity politics on steroids, isn't it?
Absolutely. Sometimes I like to challenge myself and just switch the words black and white and see what you come up with. You would say that it was discriminatory. You would say that it was racist. If black men in this country were discussed in the same manner that white men are discussed today, this nation would be up in arms. There would be another civil war, and there's no question about that. But I think that this is sort of part and parcel of what the left has become. Every election cycle, they drum up this imaginary enemy, this boogeyman. I think in the 2016 election cycle, it was definitely police officers. And I think that we're seeing that they're going to continue this push on trying to attack white men so that people aren't actually thinking about the issues, plain and simple.
So, D, are the Democrats and the Democrat Party leadership doing themselves any favors? I mean, Robert O'Rourke, he goes by Beto. Why is he being attacked for who he is?
I think because America historically has basically had white men at the helm of all politics. And I think when you talk about identity politics, we can't just look at race. We also have to look at gender. And we know that the Democratic Party is the big tent. However, historically, minorities have been discriminated against, and not just in the Democratic Party, but look also in the Republican Party. In the 115th Congress, you have only one African-American serving in the United States Senate. That's a Republican. I mean, we only have two in the, you know, the Democratic side, but still, even
but
the women,
who sets the requirements for this? You have one of the most powerful groups in politics in this country called the Congressional Black Caucus. They're almost a protected class in Washington. They have a lot of power. Frederica Wilson, Sheila Jackson Lee, Maxine Waters. The list goes on, and you've got a new generation in Cory Booker and others. So is it really about victimization and victimhood? A quick one from you, and I want to go to Candace.
It's not even about victimization. It's about looking like America. The Democratic Party looks like America. The Republican Party does not. And so, you know, the Republican Party needs to have an internal discussion within themselves to say, how can we make our party look like America?
Okay, so Candace, do we have to look like the right mix? Is it 17% Hispanic, 12% Black, this percent women?
No.
I mean, who sets these standards? And isn't it about qualifications? Isn't it about what you're capable of, what your skill sets are, and how you serve your community, regardless of which party you come from?
That's exactly right. And look, here's what the left wants you to believe. They want you to think that diversity is everybody looking differently but thinking the same. The only true diversity is intellectual, and there is none on the left. There are no disputes on the left. They're all in lockstep. And I, you know, I always find it a little bit strange when you encounter a black woman like Dee, who knows the history of her party, who brought us the KKK, Jim Crow laws. Absolutely no progress has been accomplished despite fact that they've had our vote for the last 6 decades. And they stand up here and they boldface tell you that the left is going to help the black race in some regard. That's just dishonest, you know. But here's the thing: they're going to have to switch their platform. They are losing.
The white men
are losing the black vote. They know that despite this rhetoric, No, they did not. The Democrats brought me the KKK, so that's dishonest.
No,
I'm going to tell you that right
KKK,
now.
Okay?
So
either black
you don't wear the white
history,
or you're choosing
no, you
to be dishonest.
Have you seen a black
like,
man wearing a white
shirt?
Okay.
Nobody
can hear that. That's not what I said. So you're moving the
ladies,
on.
Time
I didn't
cut you off. Time out, D. Candace, time out. Time out.
D, I didn't cut you off.
Time right now on TV.
I'm finishing my statement.
Candace, could you finish your thought? D, I'll give you a chance for a quick response.
I certainly like to. Everybody understands the history. If any black person that knows their history knows at the helm of any racist act in this country, Democrats were in control of it. Now they're trying to seize the narrative and make us think that we somehow should be afraid of Republicans or afraid of conservative principles, when in fact, the most progress that we've had in the last 6 decades has been under President Donald Trump. And I think that we're going to see in 2020 that more black Americans are going to stand behind him because we're tired of this fear-mongering rhetoric, which is being perpetuated.
All right, Candace, I've only got to pause you because I need to give Dee, I'm sorry, but I've just got to give you a short response. Go ahead.
I'm just saying that black men have never been, or any type of black person has ever been the head of the KKK. And Candace, even when there was this big party at the White House this year,
okay,
they brought
Dee,
you in. Did
Dee,
you not throw up with a bunch of black people?
No
did
black
you not
person
do that?
Was ever going to be
not
the head of the KKK.
You,
all right,
not
ladies,
even to bring you in, bring
this
black
is actually over because we're not advancing the conversation at all.
Okay.
We'll be right back.